Today's clock is made from rough cast aluminium. And when I say rough cast, boy, do I mean rough cast. I don't know where this clock would have been made or when. I'm assuming it was made before the war, because after the war I would imagine that aluminium would have been in very short supply. And there's quite a thickness of aluminium in that case. It's not a lightweight clock. I'm assuming it was made in Soviet Russia. I'll explain why later. Now, that pendulum doesn't belong to it. I just got that pendulum in the post short ago. I haven't had a chance to test the clock with that pendulum yet. It's already a minute fast and it hasn't been going for very long. That doesn't bode well, so I'll probably have to change that pendulum. That weight doesn't belong to it either. I have no idea where that weight came from. It doesn't look like it was intended as a clock weight with that strange bucket handle. The cord I just bought on eBay short ago. And I bought a blue cord because the clock had blue hands. Okay, here's the clock close up. Now, I ultrasonically cleaned this case. I put it in the ultrasonic cleaner, I think, three times, because I wasn't sure if it was getting properly cleaned. Every time it came out, it looked dirty. It took me a little while to realise that the reason why it looked dirty is because of all the tiny imperfections in the surface of the metal, all of which were creating tiny shadows and making it look dirty from some angles. Because the surface of the clock, the entire surface, is extremely rough. Now, the numerals were painted. The paint had more or less all worn off when I put it in the ultrasonic cleaner. The last remnants of the blue paint disappeared. I probably will repaint the numerals at some stage, but I'm not in a hurry to do that. It looks fine with the numerals just cast in the metal like that. I might repaint the numerals at some stage. I've already repainted the hands. They were blue. It's not the same shade of blue, but I had this shade of blue in the workshop, and it looks nice. It's not exactly the same shade. It's not that far off. So the hands had some finish, even though the rest of the clock didn't. Now, to show you just how roughly cast this is, I mean, that's the side of the clock. Look at all those imperfections. Just look at that beautiful finish. I mean, that is how the clock left the factory. And I assume that is how the clock looked when it was hanging up on the wall. And that's not the worst of it. The worst of it, up here, look at that. I mean, that is just magnificent casting work, it really is. And again, all these bits here, they look dirty, but they're not. It's just the imperfections in the surface of the metal make tiny shadows and make it look dirty from some angles. And the front's not free of casting flaws either. Whatever factory made this clock, they couldn't care less about how it looked. But at least they made nicely shaped hands. They painted them blue, and they painted the numerals blue. So I suppose if this clock was hanging high enough up the wall, it wouldn't matter if the casting was that bad. And here's the inside of the rough cast aluminium wall clock. This is why I don't believe this was made in somebody's workshop, because these ribs and that hanging mount, they've been designed quite intricately in the mould. And if you'll notice, this movement is fixed in with a screw here and a horseshoe mount, I don't know what you call that, a horseshoe to hold it in place. Now, that part there is part of the casting that is threaded for this screw, and these parts underneath have a slot cut in them at exactly the right position to hold this movement in place. Now the movement itself is quite interesting. It's very small, that's my hand in relation to the movement. It's just what's what I call a three-wheeler, a 24-hour weight-driven movement. It's been made from metal that's been dotted. That is not usually found in German clocks, but it is often found in Russian clocks. Also, the wheels are dotted. And that is something I've never seen in German clocks, but I have seen in Russian clocks. So I'm wondering if this clock was made in Soviet Russia. Now, that blue cord doesn't belong to the clock. I bought that cord. Also, this pendulum leader, that's just one I found in a drawer. The actual crutch is just as basic as can be. It's just a wire crutch. Now, I ultrasonically cleaned this movement as well, and it went a funny colour. It's quite common for brass to go a funny colour when it's ultrasonically cleaned. It doesn't always happen, but it happened with this one. I took every wheel out, ultrasonically cleaned the whole lot, and I cleaned it all afterwards with metal cleaner. In fact, I polished it with Brasso just to get rid of the strange coppery colour that it had gone. And that seems to have worked reasonably well. And there's some tension on that cord at the moment, so the wheels will turn. It works quite well for being a basic movement. So that's the inside of the rough cast aluminium clock, and you see all the imperfections there on the inside of the case as well. Absolutely no effort made to cover the imperfections or apply any kind of finish whatsoever. So it's not finished yet, but I dare say it will be another almost worthy addition to my collection. Okay, if you like this video, please click like and subscribe. My Facebook link is down below, and my PayPal link if you would like to support this channel. And I'll see you in the next video.